Hello, my name is Eric. With Google Earth, I located a shipwreck in March 2016 near Disco Island. The island lies between Greenland and continental America. For much of the year, it is covered by snow and ice of the Arctic Circle. During the brief summer, the ice melts in the midnight sun and reveals structures otherwise unseen. The first impression was that the wreck had the outline of a Viking longship. Measurements were taken using satellite images. It was intriguing that the wreck lay near ancient Viking routes to America. January 2017, James Delgado verified that the shipwreck was archaeologically unknown. He had explored the Fox 975 meters south of the unknown vessel in 2003. June 2017, we first learned the name of the shipwreck. Research into Lloyd's shipping register from 1863 followed. The Wildfire was built 1853 in Quebec, Canada, then belonged to the Scottish Dundee whaling fleet. The Wildfire in the foreground was built as a steam screw ship. Wildfire was one of three ships owned by the Tay Whale Fishing Company. The Wildfire got damaged by severe nips in Baffin's Bay, damaging her propeller. The captain continued to sail her for 500 miles to Godhaven Harbor. On the 18th of July, 1868, she reached her final destination. The photo of the wreck is from 1876. This was our first glimpse of the wreck site, taken from the Godhaven Ferry. We then explored the area on foot. The outline of the Wildfire was visible from the shore. The wreck lies approximately 50 meters away from the shore. The low depth of the wreck and the clear water makes it easy to spot it from afar. With the assistance of the Arctic Station, we took a boat to the site. My wife Carol came along for expedition support. Plan A was to use a camera on a stick to film the wreck from the surface. That didn't work out too well. Instead, Plan B came into effect. The water has a temperature of 2 degrees Celsius. The dive begins at the bow, the front of the boat, diving along the starboard side. Towards the stern, back of the wreck. From the book The Dundee Whalers, 1750 to 1914 by Norman Watson. Albert Markham noted in 1873 that pieces of ice of considerable magnitude broken off by our repeated charges, would pass along under the bottom of the ship and, emerging up the screw aperture, prevent the propeller from performing its revolutions and therefore bringing the engine to a dead stop. And when the Wildfire damaged her propeller in 1868, she managed to limp 500 miles to Disco Island, only to be abandoned there. The whole wreck is heavily overgrown by algae. The timbers or ribs of the ship are well preserved. Here we see the chimney or mast. This long object lies on deck along the center line. Here we are moving towards the stern. The stern appears very narrow. Unidentifiable artifacts lie on the seafloor. Turning to make a second pass. Along the port side. The illusion of the pointy stern vanishes. Captain Walker of the Wildfire recorded an extraordinary episode in the bay when the Dundee fleet was gripped by some of the worst conditions experienced in the Arctic. The whaling fleet was at a latitude of 70 degrees north, some 35 miles off Cape Sethian, when
"We were brought to a standstill, in fact to our wits' ends. We could neither advance nor retreat. We were jammed and unable to move the ship in any way to a place where we could have the least protection. In short, we were six of the finest vessels that ever navigated these congealed seas, lying close together to be shoved up at the mercy of the immense floes. I have been on a lee shore more than once, and I have seen death staring me in the face. We had to stand with our hands in pockets, could do nothing but look on, expecting every moment to see our good ships made mincemeat of."
Walker and the 300 men of the Dundee fleet were powerless to interfere with nature's work. Here comes one dark timber that looks exposed. coming to the bow of the ship and turning. I made several attempts at reconstructing the wreck. First, I created picture mosaics from the approximately 300 single exposures of the Rolle Action Cam 500. The perspective appears distorted. The lens focal length is 2.36 and it isn't adjusted to the water refraction. To get clearer images, I used Agisoft Photoscan. Due to my lack of experience, I've not been able to reconstruct the whole ship. Realistically, it is hard to imagine that it is lying on the deck. This is the port side of the model, bow on the right. The bow in a still image. That's the stern. This is the starboard side of the wreck, bow on the right. The 3D scan can be compared to the satellite image showing the location. Thank you for watching and listening.